plan was to cut all this up for firewood, but this must be 14, 16 inches wide. I'm going to cut that into four pieces. That will become four platters on the lathe. Maybe, unless I screw one up again. This one. Which I will cut down to an inch and a half board. This one has the saw kerf where I dug a nail out. I dug for a nail or nail holes. Okay, the rest is board. Well, as we say in the trade, ouch. That must be the one I was digging for. Okay, it's right here. That's the chainsaw cut from where there's a nail in there. I can't see it. Maybe the head's below this bark. I don't know, but when you look over here, there it is. Doesn't come out here. So it's gotta be right here. But it's not. So maybe it was in straight enough that that blade and that shower of sparks spit the whole rest of the nail out. Well, you can see we're going to have to change the blade. Look at that offset. That tooth is offset up quite a bit to leave these ridges here. Okay, I got three blades left before we sharpen. And to really add insult to injury, I didn't go down quite far enough. I'm perfect here, but over here, need another half inch. If I'd gone down another half inch, we'd not have hit this nail. hit it this way and see where that comes out. It doesn't come out. And I think that went down through the crack in the floor. Five teeth in a row that were bent up, down in this view. The five that hit the nail, well, make that six. Here's one with the tip gone. There's one with steel on it. Okay, we hit about the teeth starting here. Yep, there's a shard of steel broken off that. Just then, oh, it got about a foot and a half of teeth, but look at these. That one particularly. Get a dark background here so you can see it. Yeah, those teeth were bent up. We're at the top half of the saw now, saw blade now. So these will have to be reset. I have not kept separate categories of sharpen only and sharpen and set. So I think I'll set them all this time. But first, these have to be flattened out for unset before they can be set. Well, maybe a little crescent wrench. I don't know which ones of these are supposed to be downset, which are upset, and which are straight. And I don't care. The tooth setter will take care of all that. Get them up somewhere towards middle. Okay. Oil this one up and put on a new one. This one is pretty much guaranteed to have nails in it. It's got a rope growing into the tree. I would not be surprised if there are nails at the other end of that. First, let's see if it works. Yep, that's a nail in the floor. Well, I think this is nail free. Warm. dressed wood curls. Make nice wedges though.